Yeah, good morning YouTube. So here we're looking at my 24 volt power meter here in the garage, and the freezer's running. It's down at its low temperature now, down around 0 Fahrenheit, and compressor's running, pulling just under 0.7 amp. Yes, I'm not sure if this meter is reading correctly or not. Yes, the clamp meter's still showing like 2.3 amps, just dropped below 2.3 there. And this one's still showing 0.68. I just checked the voltage across the current shunt and I get about 2.1 millivolts. So I think this is a 75 millivolt 100 amp shunt, and that works out to like 2.8 amps. Now, funny thing is, yesterday this meter was reading like 2 point something amps. Okay, a bit of an update here. If I look at the meter, it's still reading 0.68 amps, but the freezer has shut off and now it's running, that's the standby current, about 40 milliamps roughly. Yeah, let me zero that out. So there we got zero. Yeah, there we go. That's a little more like it. There's 27 milliamps. So this is the standby current when the compressor is not running, and you can see the meter is still reading 0.68. So I think I got the meter fixed. It was two problems. One is I had the negative connection on the meter on the wrong side of the shunt because I had initially wired the shunt up wrong. Basically the input and the output wires swapped. So I swapped those on the shunt. I left the wires plugged into the meter. There's my little sketch. Yeah, so you want to have the negative power for the meter plugged into the negative on the battery side. And I had it connected over on the negative of the output side. The two ends of the shunt, you're going to have a few millivolts. So if we go on there and there, I get 2 millivolts right there across the shunt. If you multiply by 1 1/3, yeah, that's about right, 2.6, 2.5 amps right there. But yeah, I think we're in the right ballpark now. And then the other problem I had, I think while I was working with the two shunt pickup wires, I must have worked one of them loose. I think it was the negative shunt wire pulled out of the connector on the side of the meter. So I either didn't have it in all the way or I worked it loose, because I had to pull the wires off the back of the shunt and then reconnect them. And maybe when I was twisting them around, I pulled the wire loose. So I had a loose wire. You want the meter plus and minus hooked to your source or your battery side. So the plus for the meter is on the battery plus, and then minus for the meter is on the battery minus. Yeah, if you see right there, I've got L, S, minus, and plus right here on this connector. So the upper one is the load side of the shunt. The second one is the source side of the shunt or the battery side. And then minus and plus are hooked up on the battery side or your source negative. The plus, I don't think it really matters. But yeah, now we're working. So I'm at 2.5 kilowatt hours. That was what was accumulated on the meter. That was the last several days while I was fooling around with it. So I'm not too sure if that's accurate, but I'm just gonna basically start with that number. It's December 24th, and I got this hooked up about noon. So that'll be my accumulated kilowatt hours from noon on the 24th. So I'll let it run maybe for a week and get a 1 week total. And that way I can see, you know, how many kilowatt hours or watt hours does this use. And then I'll have a pretty good idea, you know, what the consumption is. Got all the wires mixed up. So now I think I've got it straight. So now I know how to hook up these DC meters. They're a little bit different than the AC meters. So yeah, anyway, I will wrap this up here. If you have any questions, post up in the comments section below. And as always, thanks for watching.